Welcome to Istanbul in Turkey and welcome to the EuroLeague Women quarterfinals. Tonight we have a replay of last year's final as Fenerbahce welcomed Sopron here to Istanbul. That night, a year ago, hearts were broken as Sopron upset all the odds, coming away with a 60-55 win. I'm sure that that has haunted some of the nightmares of the Fenerbahce players, and they would love to get revenge in this quarterfinal series. And we are now fully at the business end of the season for both of these teams. Two teams as well from different ends of the form spectrum right here today. After a relatively slow start to the season, they lost their first two games. Fenerbahce are now on a near unbelievable 12-game winning streak. They haven't lost since game day two. As for Sopron, they've really struggled in recent weeks. In fact, they had to rely on Avenida winning the last game of the regular season for them even to make it through to the quarterfinals. They have only won one of their last five games, and that was by only 2 points against Girona. This is the quarterfinals of EuroLeague Women, and we are set for a really interesting battle between last year's finalists. We are under 7 minutes away from the tip-off here in Istanbul. The crowd are starting to file in, and I'm sure they will make themselves heard throughout today's game. Sopron will be introduced to the crowd first, as they are our visitors here in Turkey. And as much as you would say Sopron are in no way in any form at the moment, you would struggle to find anyone in the basketball community that would write them off in today's game or this quarterfinal series. Sopron seem to almost flourish when their back's against the walls. Here's a schedule for the day. Cukarova taking on Borj in 30 minutes time. Praha against Avenida and Skio against Valencia are the two later tip-offs today. All of those games available through the EuroLeague Women YouTube channel, so make sure you dive onto that and jump into that content throughout today. Some really big ties, and none better than the one we've got here to get things underway. As I say, a replay of last year's finals. But for Sopron, their biggest issue has been on the offensive end. They have the third worst offense across EuroLeague Women this season, scoring just 66 points a game. And let's be honest, when you look at that Fenerbahce roster, it's likely they're going to have to get over 80 today to stand a chance of securing an upset win on the road here in the first leg of this quarterfinal. They've only done that once so far this season. So it is a big, big ask for Coach Gaspar and his team. But that does not mean that they are not going to do it. As for Fenerbahce, well, what can you say? They have been building towards potentially one of the greatest teams to ever be brought together in the history of EuroLeague Women. The roster they've brought, well, it is the biggest and best stars in basketball. Coach Malkovich done a great job in keeping all of them happy as well, making sure they've stayed on track. And this team is now starting to fire on all cylinders. Most people across Europe and within the basketball world certainly have Fenerbahce as favourites to lift the trophy, not just for this quarterfinal series, but there are some challenges ahead. And you have a feeling that Sopron will not go quietly. They will battle for a full 80 minutes in this one. Remember, it's a two-legged quarterfinal. A three-series quarterfinal, with the best of three progressing through to the final four. Both teams now going to their huddles as they really start to get themselves locked in on today's game. And they will go and shake hands on the half before getting ready to enter battle. So much experience and so much talent on both rosters. Some of the best players on the planet on this floor tonight. We are set for what could be one of the best games of the season so far, and rightfully so, as we are now here at the business end of the season in the playoffs. Just a reminder, Fenerbahce ended up the regular season with a 12-2 record. Best record in the regular season across both groups, all 16 teams. As for Sopron, they ended up with an 8-6 record, fourth place in Group B. That is why they face Fenerbahce, who ended top of Group A. And plenty of Fenerbahce fans will need to put away some of the nightmares of last season. Everything was set for them to come away with the title last year, and it didn't happen. Here's your officials for tonight: Petr Hrusa, Jelena Tomic, and Stylianos Simeoidis from Czech Republic, Croatia, and Greece, respectively. There's our officiating crew. I'm sure they're looking forward to what should be a really interesting game here as well. And these two teams certainly know each other. This history within the EuroLeague women competition alone goes back decades, and another chapter is set to be written again this season. Just a reminder, three-game series. The second game in this series is scheduled for this Friday, that one on Sopron's home floor in Hungary. And then the third leg, if it is needed, will be back here in Istanbul on Wednesday the 22nd. That's next Wednesday. So the scene is definitely set. Here is our starting five for Sopron. It's Fegvenecki, McBegor, Jukor, Brooks and Turner. That is a strong starting five that will compete with any across Europe right now. The issue at a certain point for Sopron is just the depth. The arrival of Ipupa helps, but Kunek and Stankovic will be the main ones really coming off the bench to provide support. Stankovic trying to help out in that front court, which could be certainly an area of interest here, as Fenerbahce certainly have a wealth of talent working inside. Coach Gashbar there, been leading Sopron since 2019. Knows that it is a big ask today, but he'll be up for it. Here's the starting five for Fenerbahce. It's Chaka, Messerman, McBride, Iagapova and Stewart. My goodness me, that is a mouth-watering five. And then look at some of the talent coming off the bench. Van der Sloot, Sabali, Georgievich. Wow, what a team Coach Malkovic has to work with. A roster that goes all the way down to the bottom of the bench. She is now trying to just get those final instructions across to her team. Just a reminder before we have our opening tip here, which is just moments away. If you want to follow all of the action across these quarterfinal series, not just this one here, but all of the others going on across Europe over the next week or so, then your best bet is to download the official EuroLeague Women app, available on Android and iOS. I'm sure they've got it downloaded. Your phones out now. That one's completely free of charge and plenty for you to get your teeth into in that app. But we are now just moments away from the opening tip here, and Sopron know that they're going to have to get out to a good start. They cannot afford a slow start. They need to put in a good performance early on. Both coaches making sure they use every last second available to them. It will be the details that decide the games here. This stage of the season, the finest of margins. It's the difference between winning and losing. And in this setting, is the difference between ending your season and progressing through to a Final Four. Sopron 5 onto the floor first. They're ready to go. As I say, Sopron likely wanting to gain to be a little bit slower, a little bit more thoughtful and tactical. And you just feel that Fenerbahce are just going to come out of the gates like a rocket and try and close this game out as early as they possibly can. They want the win in the bag as quick as they can, but there's no real way you can do that against a team of the quality of Sopron. Strap yourselves in. This should be a good one as we tip off the quarterfinals of this year's EuroLeague women's season. Four matchups across Europe over the next 8 days will decide who will be at the final four. And we are underway here in Istanbul. Game one of this quarterfinal series between Fenerbahce and Sopron. A big, big series ahead of us here. Chaka now to Yagapova. Yagapova turns the corner. Stolen away. Good, quick hands. Turner now hands it to McBegor. Brooks to Fegvenecki. There's a duo that have combined for, I'd hate to think how many points over the years. McBegor gets the easy two, and she is going to be crucial in today's game, averaging over 10 points and almost 8 rebounds a game. 23-year-old Australian really is going from strength to strength. Foul's going to be called on Fegvenecki. Yagapova looks to take her into the low post. That's an interesting indication early on. There's the pass inside to McBegor. Gets an early two for her. Yagapova now definitely has a strength mismatch against Fegvenecki. Messerman hands it off to Yagapova. She fakes the three. Draws the foul. That's going to be another foul, and the basket's good. Clearly, Fenerbahce have decided that is a way for them. Just the strength of Yagapova. Fegvenecki just not able to stay with her. Second foul on Fegvenecki. That's a problem for Sopron. They don't go deep. They're probably going to have to move Fegvenecki away from guarding Yagapova. Turner now to McBegor. Back to Brooks. Good fluid basketball here from Sopron. Inside to McBegor. She holds on to it. Chukor gets the score. And that is promising signs from Coach Gaspar's team. Sometimes they get a little bit stagnant on the offensive end, but they are locked in. Today's game for sure. Beautiful fadeaway, but a little heavy there from Stewart. Fegvenecki, free throw line, jumper is good. Early 3-point lead for Sopron. And they are just businesslike. They'll take the emotion out of the game. They have very, very high IQ. Plenty of composure and experience as well in that Sopron team. Oh, lovely backdoor cut for Stuart. McBegor recovers well. Chaka, spin move. Too heavy off the glass, though. Over 2 minutes gone already in this game. And you would say advantage to Sopron so far. Their offense is very, very smooth. McBegor kicks it out. Fegvenecki to Brooks. Brooks, elbow. Draws the foul from Stewart. Brooks will go to the free throw line. 4 shots. Yelena Brooks once again has been so, so important for Sopron. One of the consistents that Coach Gaspar has to lean on. Averaging just under 17 points and 5 rebounds a game. It's the first of her two. Shooting 78% this season from the free throw line. Sopron's perspective as well, they'll be happy that, yes, they have the lead, but 4 players already have points as well. They're not over-reliant on one particular player. They're spreading the load a little bit in the early stages. McBride now to Stewart. Good defense by Sopron. They're switching well. Messerman inside to Stewart. Stewart, oh, little shoulder shake. No good. Messerman with the offensive board, though. Yakupova just blast to the basket, but the finger roll wasn't there. Did all the hard work. Quick first step, did all she needed. McBegor now to Turner. Three ball goes up and goes down. Yvonne Turner has not been shooting the three ball well this season, just 15%, but she's turned up early here. Sopron's lead now at seven. Fenerbahce crowd doing what they can to get their team back in. Foul's going to be called on Turner. Xhaka will go to the line for shots. I don't mind that foul from Yvonne Turner. It's the right foul, really. Xhaka stays with it. It's the first of her two. Just 57% prior to today's game from the free throw line. Olga Xhaka. Been in the yellow and blue of Fenerbahce since 2019. Her second spell at the club, but if she had sleeves, you'd say she plays with her heart on them. Really does play with passion. Jukor getting the door shut on her. Are they going to get over the half in time? They do just. Fekvenecki now. Just 10 seconds to work with. She's got the horns offense set up in front of her, though. Brooks inside. Kicks it to the corner. Chukor. Little flat, and that one skips across the top of the rim. As you would expect, the crowd in full voice already. Messman, and there's the easy two, and it was all made from the millimeter-perfect pass from van der Sloot, who's coming to the game for Xhaka, and what an addition Courtney van der Sloot has been. Just her third game in EuroLeague Women this season, averaging 10 points, 5 boards, 9 assists, and 2.5 steals in those first two. Van der Sloot really doesn't need much introduction. McBride intercepts, though. Got one-on-one with McBegor. McBegor, good defense. Van der Sloot follows but can't get the score. Fekvenecki now inside to Brooks. Brooks, little step back fade away. And that's almost a signature play for Yelena Brooks. Just a beautiful little soft touch. Takes her tally to three. Sopron's lead back out to five. McBride. Defense is strong. 3-on-2 break now. Turner, another three ball. That one's off left, though. And Stewart pulls down the rebound for Fenerbahce. Her first rebound of the game. McBride, catch and shoot. That is a quick release from McBride. One of those players that will have had the heartache from last season will be motivated and driven by that loss in the final last year. Sideline possession for Sopron. They're going to make some changes, though, as Messman just trying to steal it away but knocks it out of bounds. Burundi's come into the game, as has Kunek. Chukor and Fekvenecki to the bench. Three left on the shot clock. Rebound, though. No good for Kunek. She'll get her own rebound again, but misses another opportunity. Yakupova draws another foul. Game after game. Alina Yakupova, it's just that hesitation. Draws the defense in, and then just a quick first step explodes to the basket. Really leaves the defenders with no option but to foul her. First of two is good. Chance to tie the ball game up. A little under 6 minutes gone in this first quarter. And the second is good. Yakupova will take a seat as Sabali comes in. And this is the wealth of riches that Coach Malkovich has. The entire roster she has is world class. Definitely has greater depth than her counterpart. McBride, no good. Good defense by Brooks. And now the 2-on-0 transition, Burundi with the easy two. And this is what I talk about with Chopron. They don't get drawn into the emotion of the game. They try and level out the highs and lows. Very businesslike and efficient way of playing. Stewart slips through on the pick and roll. Stewart on her way to New York Liberty for next season in the WNBA, or should we say Stew York Liberty. Brooks, long two. No good. The tempo of the game, you would say, is probably favouring Fenerbahce, but Chopron are embracing it. They're enjoying getting out and running and being a little bit more fluid. Vandersloot drives inside, reverse layup, a little heavy-handed. Foul will be called, though, as Brianna Stewart was trying to pull down the rebound. Let's see who the foul's going to be called on. I presume it's on McBegor. That will be the second on her as well. In fact, it's on Burundi. Just her first foul, but Stewart will go to the line for free throw. Chopron in the penalty. Fenerbahce just one foul so far in this quarter. Stewart hits the first of her two, and another mid-season addition for Fenerbahce, and what a revelation. Game number 8 for Brianna Stewart tonight in EuroLeague Women, averaging over 19 points and 8 rebounds a game, and shooting 92% from the free throw line. Husky getting it done all over the world. Pupa into the game now for Chopron. Originally started the season here in Fenerbahce, but left back end of January. Messerman now throws it back to Vandersloot. Into the corner, wide open. Three ball is good. That's a big shot from Onar coming in off the bench. Nailing the three. That's exactly what Coach Malkovich wants. She wants just a relentless wave of offense from her team. And now Fenerbahce's lead is at a game high 5. Brooks, free throw line jumper, comes up short. Probably would have been better dumping that one down too. McBegor. Onar again. Not this time though. Rebound pulled down by Stokes. A wonderful little slip through from Messerman. Flash to provide the screen, but slip to the basket for the easy two. And Fenerbahce now, their offense is in full swing. Their lead is up to 7. They've scored 21 points in a little over 8 minutes. And the Fenerbahce fans are certainly enjoying themselves behind that team bench. We're going to see if we can head into some of these huddles. Listen to what the coaches have to say. Unfortunately, a few issues with some of the feeds into the timeouts. 1:49 left in this first quarter. Fenerbahce lead by 7. That will have settled some nerves. Chopron started the game well. They started with confidence, almost with a nothing to lose attitude. At one point they had a 7-point lead, but now they trail by 7. However, of all the teams in EuroLeague Women this season, you would say Chopron are the ones that seem to be most resilient when they get into these situations. Epupa now hands it to the corner to Burundi. Patience here from Chopron. Still 10 on the shot clock. Epupa back to Burundi. Burundi, quick first step. Bas van der Sloot draws the foul. Vivi Burundi will head to the line for free throws. 82% free throw shooter. Just that quick first step, and van der Sloot wasn't able to react quick enough. The weak side help from Sabali was a little slow coming across as well. I'm not sure it was really Sabali's assignment to step across. Burundi gets the first of her two. It's the second. And it's that kind of free throw line performance that Chopron are going to need throughout today's game. Almost stolen away by Epupa. She's averaging two steals a game. Brooks will take a seat on the bench, having played the whole of the first quarter so far. Into the game comes Dragana Stankovic. Brings a little bit more physicality to the front court, probably needed against Stokes. Messerman using her footwork well, but the finish isn't there. Stokes with the offensive rebound, but spills possession. Kunek kicks it out of bounds, so it'll be Fenerbahce ball. Van der Sloot doesn't take the three. Selfless play from Van der Sloot. Another rebound by Stokes, but another miss by Stokes. Fourth rebound of the game, but yet to score a point, Kia Stokes. Mukbegor for three, nails it. And that is why Ezik Mukbegor is really developing into a world-class superstar. Australian's game has just gone on leaps and bounds this season. Really demonstrated what a versatile player she is. Inside to Messerman, crowded down low. Foul will be called. Not sure if that was on Mukbegor or Stankovic. But Messerman will go for shots. Yeah, absolutely harassed as she got the ball in the low post. Misses the first. Messerman's had a real standout season. Almost 16 points and 6.5 rebounds a game. That said, multiple EuroLeague women's champion, you'd expect it. Back into the game comes McBride and Yagapova. Out of the game goes van der Sloot and Messerman. And this is why Fenerbahce are tough. It will be onslaught for 40 minutes. The intensity won't drop, the quality won't drop. They will just continue, particularly offensively, to batter their opponents for the entire game. Epupa goes inside, no good. Stankovic rebound. Trying to find some space, gets the shot away, but eventually it falls to Stokes, and that will be the end of the first quarter here in Istanbul. Fenerbahce lead this one by three. A bright start from Chopron, but coach Malkovich's team settled any nerves they were feeling. And at the end of the first quarter, it's Fenerbahce that lead this one 22-19 over Chopron. Here are some of the highlights from that first quarter of action. Yagapova certainly enjoyed the first quarter. She got 5 points with a little over 6 minutes on the floor. But Chopron had the brighter of the starts, holding an early 7-point lead. Fenerbahce just started to find a little bit of rhythm as the quarter progressed. At one stage, they'd opened up a 7-point lead of their own. Chopron kept their composure, lent on their veterans, the likes of Brooks and Fegvenecki. And now they trail by just 3 points. And for Chopron, they know that this is a game that, if they're going to come away with the win, will be won in the fourth quarter. It's unlikely Chopron will blow this game open and secure a win early. They know they just need to stay in this battle until the final couple of minutes. If they're within single digits, they have a chance of picking up a huge road win and bringing it back to their home floor on Friday, with a chance to secure a spot in the final four and break Turkish hearts yet again. Second quarter underway here in Istanbul. In the first 10 minutes, it's Fenerbahce that lead by three, no longer. It's just a 1-point lead now as Turner lays it up to start the second quarter for Chopron. 2 from 3 from the field for Turner now. Sabali gets position inside, draws the foul. I think that one will be on Brooks. Chopron have already committed quite a few fouls in this game. That's the 7th personal foul of the game so far for Chopron. Fenerbahce only 2. Sabali now at the line, hits the first of her 2. And Fenerbahce are a near 82% free throw shooting team, so they are one of the best in EuroLeague women this season at shooting the free throws. In fact, they are the best. Zekzard just behind them with 81.4%. Fegvenecki now draws the foul from Yagapova. Sideline possession for Chopron. Brooks now. Fegvenecki looking for the screens, but the screens are being set way too low. She needs them a lot higher than that. Shot clock down to 7. Drive inside from Kunek. It's no good, and the defense was resilient to say the least. Yagapova now to Stokes. Fenerbahce know they can be patient. Sabali inside, gets position, gets the score. And it was just the size mismatch that she secured against Turner was enough to get her the points. Stankovic, a little heavy-handed, and you just feel that Fenerbahce are now really wrestling control of this game. Oh, defense, though, by Turner. As Sabali is rejected from behind. Let's have a look at the replay. Can't see whether it's clean or not. Sabali didn't look too happy. Just her first foul though, but second foul of the quarter for Fenerbahce. Just 90 seconds in. Brooks, I think she had a lot more space than she realized and didn't think she was expecting to be that wide open, but she took too long and Sabali gets the block. Oh, Yagapova, killer crossover. Doesn't get the score though. What a handle from Yagapova. Goes inside, can't quite connect with the layup off the glass. Sideline possession now for Fenerbahce. Back into the game comes Epupa. As is Van der Sloot as well for Fenerbahce. Sabali, quick catch and shoot, but it was well guarded. Fenerbahce's lead stays at 5. Pushing foul will be called on Sabaly. That's going to be her second foul. And potentially Coach Malkovich will have some foul issues to consider. Apupa to Thegvenecki. Back to Apupa. Oh, lovely backdoor cut. Brooks a little too busy thinking about what she was going to do with the ball before she'd even got hold of it. Van der Sloot now to McBride. When you look at the five on the floor for Fenerbahce, they are all scorers. That time though, Stewart off target with the three ball. Apupa now waits for the screen from Stankovic. But the screens are being set completely the wrong place at the moment for Sopron. I don't know if it's because Fenerbahce are dropping and they're not playing tight, tough defense. 3-on-2 break. Jagopova, the pass to McBride is a poorly placed pass. Scrappy minute or so of the game here in the second quarter. Apupa now to Brooks. Thegvenecki has to throw a prayer up and they're answered. Nails the three ball. Not the shot she wanted, but the shot clock forced her into it. Sopron within two. Jagopova now kicks it out to Messerman. Messerman trying to find Van der Sloot. Instead, it will be just sideline possession for Fenerbahce. Back into the game comes Dorma Chukor for Sopron. Also in McBegor as Stankovic and Kunek go to the bench. McBride, long three. Nails another three ball. Kayla McBride, her second of the game. McBegor inside. Oh my goodness. How did she get the shot away, let alone make it? Manages to score, even though the double team came pretty hard at her. That one's off the foot, so it'll be a shot clock reset to 14 for Fenerbahce. Jagopova inside to Stewart. Just composure in the low post for Brianna Stewart. Brooks now drives inside, uses the glass well, and that was just a great read and react from Yelena Brooks there. Just saw what the defense offered her, and they offered her a lane to the basket, but Jagopova is in dominant form today, just going straight at the defense. 7 points for Jagopova already. Thegvenecki now to Apupa. Apupa drives inside, quick first step, almost shuffles her feet, misses the layup though. Van der Sloot. McBride downtown, short this time. Rebound for McBegor, her first rebound of the game. Ah, oh, lovely pass inside. Thegvenecki just gets the roll though. She was a little surprised by the amount of space she got so close to the basket. Thegvenecki up to 7 points as well. As the tempo of the game has started to pick up again. Messerman inside will draw the foul off McBegor. Is that the third foul on Ezzie McBegor? If it is, that could be a problem. Just second foul on McBegor as Aydin comes in for Yagapova. Messerman connects with the first from the free throw line. What a season Emma Messerman has had. Can't really be surprised as she's one of the true greats in EuroLeague women's recent years. But you still have to be impressed by the way she plays the game. So smart. Reads the game beautifully at both ends. McBegor now inside is tied up by Van der Sloot, but the foul has been called. Sideline possession for Chopronier. Van der Sloot just putting her irons across the wrists of McBegor. She'll head to the bench after picking up that foul. Onar will come in her place. Fegvenecki now. Shot clock to three. Dukor has to put the shot up really. Don't think she really wanted to have to take that shot under such pressure. Fenerbahce's lead at 5. 4 minutes left in his first half. Fade away. Too much of a fade away this time for Stewart. That puts her at 2 from 7 from the field now. Not the most efficient night so far for Brianna Stewart. Nice pass into the low post. Brooks using the pivot well, but Stewart stays with it and gets the block. Eventually the rebound is pulled down by Messerman. Onar hands it away now. McBride with the crossover, rejected though by Fegvenecki. What a handle, but the defense is more than a match. Messerman now moves it out to Onar. Back to Messerman, little shake, drives inside. That'll be a shot clock violation. Just a little bit of a mental lapse from Fenerbahce there, not registering how little time was left as Coach Malkovic looks on. That one's stolen. Messerman tries to pass it out, but a good read by Epupa. Burundi inside to McBegor. Oh, what a play by Ezzy McBegor, but Chukor, no finish for her. Chopron will get to go again, though. Poor pass by Brooks. The wingspan of Stewart, too much. Stewart will draw the foul from Yelena Brooks. Unbelievably, both teams shooting the three ball better than they are from inside the arc. Fenerbahce 42% from outside. Chopron 50%. Whilst respectively 28% and 39% from 2-point. Timeout called by Coach Gashbar as his team trail by 5 with a little over 2.5 minutes left in his first half. Important 2.5 minutes of basketball ahead of both of these teams now, really. Chopron, if they go into the halftime locker room trailing by just five, that's not the end of the world. They know they just need to be in the hunt throughout the game. For Fenerbahce, they will want to try and close this one out as early as possible. They don't want it to go to a lottery of a fourth quarter. Realistically, I'm sure Coach Malkovich has challenged their team to try and have a double-digit lead for the locker room. Stewart hits the first of her two free throws. And the second is good as well. Increased pressure here now from Fenerbahce, applying a little bit more full court pressure as well. They certainly have the depth in roster to do so. Burundi going against Messman, trying to shake her with the crossover. Goes off the glass, rebound by Brooks, but it's stolen away by Aydin. Eventually, Fenerbahce do secure possession. Nice pass. What a baseline cut from Stewart. That's just great team offense, reading each other well. And Fenerbahce's lead, in a blink of an eye, is out to a game-high 9 points now. Under 2 minutes left in the first half. Oh, lovely pass inside by Brooks, and Chukwu wide open for the easy score. And we've seen that several times tonight already. The fact that Fenerbahce, maybe you could challenge a little overcommitted on the perimeter and leave the paint way unprotected. Good defense by Burundi for Shoprom. Catch and shoot, long two, no good. Long rebound falls to Messerman. Shoprom rushing that possession a little too much. Stolen away as Shoprom fronted Stewart. Brooks now off the glass, easy two with the left hand. And this is what Shoprom do. It's just consistency from Shoprom. Nothing overly glamorous, nothing overly complicated. Just consistent basketball. They're back within five again. That would have been a hell of a make from Messerman. Next to no space to even get the shot away. Had to put a lot of spin off it to try and get the backboard to help her out. Epupa now comes back to Burundi. Burundi looks to drive to the basket. She's going to draw the foul off Aydin. Both teams in the penalty. Smart play by Vivi Burundi. Just maybe catching Aydin slightly napping. At the line for two. This is the first of her two. It's the second. Shoprom back within four. Both teams making a change. As we see Stankovic come into the game, McBegor head to the bench. Yagapova also coming in for Fenerbahce. She replaces Aydin. Vanda Sloot has replaced Onar for Fenerbahce as well. McBride now, as they try and almost deny possession to Vanda Sloot. Yagapova, pick and roll with Messerman. Stolen away. No, they hold on to it. Foul will be called, I think, on Stankovic. That will send Stewart to the line for shots. Yeah, Stankovic just really getting caught out there, really. No intention to foul. Stewart misses the first of her two free throws. Her first miss of the night. Makes the second though, so she moves to 5 from 6 from the free throw line, and the first player to tick over into double digits now with 11 points, Brianna Stewart. Brooks up over the half, 12 seconds left on this first half clock. as expected, a real tussle between two world-class teams. Burundi, a little pump fake mid-air, and that will be the end of the first half of action here in Istanbul. What a first 20 minutes we've had. As you would expect, two quality teams going toe-to-toe in the first game of a three-game series. EuroLeague Women quarterfinals at the half. Game one, it's Fenerbahce 40, Sopron 35. There's the quarter breaks. Slightly wrong the graphic there, as Fenerbahce have won both quarters, winning the first quarter 22-19 and the second quarter 18-16. That's why they hold a five-point lead at the half. And again, they have spread the love around the team. Brianna Stewart leading the way with 11 points and 3 rebounds. But both Messerman and Yagapova have 7 points apiece. As for Sopron, their leading scorers are Fegvenecki, Brooks and McBegor, all with 7 points in that first half. Here are some of the highlights from that first half of action. We will have all of the second half live coming up shortly. So if you need to go and grab some snacks or a beverage, please do that now. But make sure you are back in time for the start of the second half, because you have a feeling that this one is going to go all the way to the wire. I'll see you back shortly for all that second half action. Welcome back to Istanbul. This is game one of the EuroLeague Women quarterfinal series between Fenerbahce and Sopron. We're halfway through this one. A really intriguing first 20 minutes of action. And with half in the books, it's Fenerbahce that lead this one 40-35 over Sopron. At times, Fenerbahce really showing us the quality that we've all been raving about so far this season. Their leading scorer, Brianna Stewart, she has 11 points and 3 rebounds at the half. But just behind her, Messerman has 7, as does Yagapova. McBride on 6. As for Sopron, 3 players leading the way for them. Brooks, Fegvenecki and McBeggar all on 7 points apiece. And Sopron, as you would expect, have shown a really unified front throughout that first 20 minutes. It's business as usual for Sopron. They know that they just need to stay within touching distance of Fenerbahce. If they can be within single digits in the last 2 or 3 minutes of the game, they have a chance of causing the upset and really flipping the series on its head. Remember, this is game one of a 3-game series. Game two will take place on Friday on Sopron's home floor before we return back here for a game three, if it is needed, next Wednesday. That's Wednesday the 22nd of March. This is one of 4 games taking place tonight. The game one of all 4 quarterfinals takes place tonight. Chukarova tipped off slightly after. We have Praha against Avenida will take place just after the conclusion of this game, and then Skio against Valencia will be an hour later than that. So all 4 of the game ones taking place today, all 4 of the game twos will take place on Friday, and then all 4 game threes, if needed, are slated for next Wednesday. We're almost ready for the second half tip-off here in Istanbul. Just a reminder to get your phones out, download the official EuroLeague Women app. No excuses. Make sure you get that downloaded straight away. Sopron back on the floor. They're ready to go. Kunek, McBeggar, Fegvenecki, Brooks, 5-4. Fenerbahce, their starting 5, return to the floor. McBride, Yagapova, Chaka, Stewart and Messerman. Second half underway here in Istanbul. Game one of this quarterfinal series in EuroLeague Women 4. Fenerbahce and Sopron at the half. Fenerbahce lead it by 5. Chaka now to Messerman. It's batted away but falls to Yagapova. She's got the mismatch that she wanted, as has Messerman in the low post. Good double team help though from Alice Kunek. Good timing on the help as well. McBeggor going to hand it off to Kunek. Sopron patient here offensively. Oh, wonderful screen and a backdoor cut for McBeggor. But it's Kunek that you have to give the credit to. That backdoor screen, perfectly placed and timed. McBride now. Back to Chaka. Fenerbahce's lead just 3 points. Yagapova, 3 ball on the wing, in and out. McBeggor with another rebound. Coast to coast, gets the score to Kunek. Just like that, Fenerbahce's 5-point halftime lead is down to a single point now. Stewart drives down the throat of the lane. Finger roll is a little short though. Turner glides inside, hands it off to Kunek, and Sopron have the lead. What a way to start the second half. A 6-0 run in just over 90 seconds. Fenerbahce rocked here early in the second half. No real surprise. Coach Malkovich has to call a timeout. Not the reaction she wanted to see from her team coming out into the second half. The crowd are doing their part, trying to cheer their team back into the game. How will Fenerbahce react now? It's a very early timeout that Coach Malkovich has been forced to burn there. She knows how dangerous Sopron can be when they're confident and when they're fully flowing. Early change as well as Van der Sloot comes into the game for Cheka. How will that change things? Maybe a little bit more composure. Van der Sloot, more of a innovative facilitator. McBride now to Sabali. She's into the game for Yagapova. To the corner, McBride for three! Kayla McBride, one of the best distance shooters in the game right now. McBegor. To Turner, Kunek, corner pocket three, no good, a little flat on the release. Stewart, back to McBride, quick release for McBride. Oh, back-to-back triples for Kayla McBride. Getting it done from distance. And what a swing, Fenerbahce's lead back out to five. Begor into the corner, Kunek wide open. Corner three is good this time though. Wow, what a blistering start to this second half. Both of these teams firing up the offense. Fegvenecki chasing hard on McBride. She's going to get called for the foul. That will be her third foul. And you have to, the way McBride has played in the last minute and a half has been unreal. It's just the speed of that release. She has to have just millimeters of space to be able to get a high percentage shot away. Sabali to Van der Sloot. She loses possession though. Complacency, 4-1 break. Turner. Oh, but the miss from Burundi. They can't afford those mistakes. McBegor almost steals it back, but will just slow down transition by batting it out of bounds instead. Van der Sloot to Stewart. Little big and little game on the wing. Van der Sloot goes in amongst the trees, and Kunek looks to grab the rebound, but hadn't quite re-established herself on the floor before she did so. So that would be an out of bounds. Stolen away. Good inbounds defense there from Sopron. They trail by two. McBegor now. Hands it off to Kunek. Still 10 left on the shot clock for Sopron to work with. Burundi. Tries to draw the foul from Stewart. Pulls up for the long two and makes amends for missing the fast break layup. Ties the game at 46. Van der Sloot back out to Messerman. Sabali for three. Rattles it home. Satu Sabali. Shooting 46% from downtown this season, Sabali. Three ball goes up. That one's heavy from Turner, though. McBride, no good. Followed by Stewart. But Fenerbahce just rushing their offense a little at times. Almost in a rush to try and get this game done rather than picking the best options. Oh, that is a play from McBegor. Faked the entire Fenerbahce team into thinking she was going to hand it off at the top and just slipped to the basket for the easy two. That is why reading and reacting to what the defense offers you is so important. Don't just run through the motions of what the set play is. What options have you've been gifted as the players developed? Shot clock running out. Messerman gets it away in time and gets the score. Goodness me. That's composure from Messerman and from Van der Sloot. Foul will be called on Messerman, though, as she reaches in and knocks McBeagle to the floor. Let's have a look at the replay. Yeah, it's an easy one for the officials. Burundi to Turner. Good defense by Van der Sloot, though. Just shut the door on her. Shot clock down to three. Burundi almost travels. Kicks it to Turner. Corner three goes up. Too heavy, though. Fenerbahce's defense just ratcheted up a few gears in that possession. Unbelievably, just 4.5 minutes left of this third quarter. It's been blistering. Messerman fades away and gets the two to go. What a play by Emma Messerman. McBeagle now looking for some options, but Fenerbahce's defense is starting to really apply some pressure that they haven't so far in this game. Turner, spin move, gets the roll off the glass. Yvonne Turner really is one of the gatekeepers for Sopron. If she plays well, Sopron usually do. Defensive rebound for her. She sparks the fast break. Steps back. Free throw line. Jumper is good for Turner. Double digits now for Yvonne Turner. She's up to 11 points. 5 from 7 from the field. Sopron back to within one. Sabali. Going up against Kunek. Tough play by Sabali, but Kunek with a physical brand of defense. Knocked out of bounds. Sopron will retain possession, though. As McBride heads to the bench, Yagapova comes back in. Messerman does well, really, to time that attempted steal. Turner and Kunek out for Sopron. Epupa and Chukor come in. As Coach Gaspar tries to rotate as best he can. Oh, and that's an early score. Back on the floor, Dorma Chukor gets the score. 6 points for her now. This has been a much more rounded performance from Sopron as a team. Getting contributions throughout the bench. And Sabali just really plays hard to get her points right now. Nothing overly graceful. Just a fair bit of determination. Shot clock down to 9. McBeagle trying to find Burundi. Chukor now. Lovely pass inside. That's a great find from Olivia Pupa to McBeagle. Sopron's team basketball. This is the best I've seen them play in quite a few weeks now. They've come together as a team again, and often you find that with Sopron. Adversity. Oh, what a play though. Yagapova bullies away to the basket for the score. Head to the free throw line for the bonus. Again, just reacted to the defense opening up for her. But as I was saying, Sopron, this is their best performance for weeks, and you just feel with Sopron that they draw on any of the negativity that other people bring to them and kind of have a point to prove. It certainly has cemented them as a team here today so far. Burundi heads to the bench. Fegvenecki comes in. And Yagapova is at the line to try and convert the three-point play. And she does. Fenerbahce's lead at 2. Do remember, this is top of Group A, Fenerbahce, against fourth placed in Group B, Sopron. The form book would suggest this should be quite easy for Fenerbahce, but anyone that knows anything about this level of basketball knows there's no such thing as an easy quarterfinal in EuroLeague Women's. Yagapova, the crossover, is off the foot of Brooks. Shot clock to 14. Van der Sloot back to Yagapova. Run the pick and roll, but the defense flexes well. Shot clock down to two. Going to have to get a shot away. Van der Sloot throws the prayer. It's short. Apulpa with the rebound. Initiates the fast break. Oh, millimeter perfect pass. And the finish is good for Brooks. That ties the game. 58 apiece. Under a minute and a half left in this third quarter. Sabali. Crossover. Just meets a green wall, puts the jumper up though. That is composure from Satu Sabali. And a real back and forth battle between these two. Fegvinecki to Apupa. Drives inside, kicks it to the wing. Three ball goes up. That one's heavy though from Chukor. Into the final minute of this third quarter. Nice move by Van der Sloot. Doesn't get the score. But a partner in crime, Brianna Stewart, ready to scoop up the scraps. Offensive board and an easy two for her. Fenerbahce's lead now at four. And a 6 second differential between the third quarter clock and the shot clock. Fegvinecki makes the cut. Lovely pass. Has to come back out. McBeggar will put the three ball up, though, as the shot clock was expiring. Final shot of the quarter now for Fenerbahce. Yagapova comes up short. Quarter of action that was. Time for us all to catch our breaths. My goodness me. You've got to love playoff basketball here in this season's EuroLeague Women. Sopron winning that quarter by a single point, outscoring Fenerbahce 23-22. First quarter that Sopron have won. And they trail by just 4 points. Fourth quarter action underway. 10 more minutes left in game one here in this quarterfinal series between Fenerbahce and Sopron. Fenerbahce lead by four. This one is going to go all the way to the wire. Brooks now Drives inside, mid-range two, the rattle no good. Van der Sloot just reaching over the top of Epupa for the offense, for the defensive rebound. Sabaly off left. Both teams looking for early shots. Pace of the game doesn't look like it's going to slow down. Yelena Brooks now just a single point and three rebounds away from a double-double. Epupa into the corner. Three ball a little too heavy there from Kunek. That is her game. Watch her try and stretch the floor as she goes to corners. Yagapova inside to Sabaly. Sabaly going to try and bully Kunek. Double team drops in. Foul called. Kunek needs that help. When Sabaly gets her locked down into the low post, Kunek just isn't going to be able to play the defense to keep her out. Sabaly having a bit of a height advantage, but it's just more about the strength that Sabaly has that Kunek will struggle to stop. Into the game comes Stankovic as McBegor heads to the bench. Van der Sloot now to Stewart. Crowd continue to bring the noise. Messerman, little drop step, goes to the right hand, hook is no good. And fatigue and the sense of occasion will start to play its part in this game now. As Messerman almost wipes out one of the ad boards. Trying to chase down the loose ball. Chopron will have 13 seconds to work with now. Inside to Stankovic. She's locked Sabaly down low, but she can't get the finish. As Messerman spills it out of bounds. Stankovic there with a really big job on Sabaly. Just locked her so deep in the paint that the finish wasn't quite up to the same standard. Fenerbahce fans, as always, raucous. Truly are the sixth player on the floor for the team in yellow and blue. Pass inside to Stankovic. It's knocked away, though. The double team of Van der Sloot and Sabaly does its job. Sabaly going coast to coast, hands it off to Messerman. Oh, what team offense. Sabaly ends up on the floor. It's really beautiful team basketball from Fenerbahce. And that's going to push Chopron into a timeout. A little under 8 minutes to play in the game. Selfless play there from Sabaly. Coach Gaspar needs to talk things over. Willing to burn one of his timeouts early here in the fourth. Knows that he can't afford for really Fenerbahce to get out into double digits. Needs to keep his team close. If they're close with a minute or two still playing, then you would pretty much say this is anyone's game. The favorite tags for Fenerbahce kind of goes out of the window if the game is that close in the closing stages. As you would expect, as always, cool, calm and collected. Really does embody Chopron basketball, what it is, how they approach the game. Coach Malkovich trying to grab every last second with the team. Always brings the style, Coach Malkovich. On and off the floor. Gaspar at the other end of the floor, looking dapper as well. Maybe both coaches are slightly more disheveled than when they started the game, though, as the pressure just increases on them as the game progresses. But that's what they love. They want to be in the big games. No one wants to be sitting at home on their sofas watching this. You want to be courtside involved. Rebound. Knocked out of bounds by Stewart. That's a good chase down, really, by Olivier Ipupa. Baseline ball for Sopron to Stankovic. Sopron will take their time. They've shown patience tonight. Long two goes up. That one's heavy. Stankovic tries to bat it back, and she does to Brooks. And this is what Stankovic has brought to Sopron. Remember, they have suffered with the loss of Bernadette Hattar for the majority of the season. Stankovic has done her best to fill those rather large shoes. Do bear in mind, Stankovic is 13 centimetres shorter than Hattar, so a very different front court player. Van der Sloot now. Jakpova, little sidestep, step back. Three is good. Jakpova with some beautiful footwork to create enough space and time to get the three ball away. That will be called on Messerman. Turner saw a glimmer of light for her to attack. Yeah, Messerman called for the foul. That's an easy one for the officials. Fenerbahce's lead now out to 9 points. This is a crucial phase in the game. McBegor and Dukors come in for Turner, Stankovic and Kunek, and Fegvenecki's in as well. So three changes here for Coach Gaspar. As he sees this as a tipping point, no doubt. Ipupa to Dukors for three, in and out, rebound by Stewart, but you have to give a huge amount of credit for Van der Sloot there. Locking out McBegor, boxing her out, giving Stewart really the easy rebound. Brianna Stewart now just a one rebound away from that double-double as Courtney Van der Sloot unbelievably gets her first score of the game. One from seven from the field for her. McBegor goes inside, draws the foul off Messerman. Earns a trip to the free throw line. Have a look at the replay. Just a change of direction from McBegor causing Messerman the issue. Third personal foul for Messerman. Shouldn't be a problem. If I'm Sopron, I'm potentially going to target Emma Messerman and try and attack her now. McBegor misses the first of her two. It's the second. And a Sloot brings it over the half. Under 6 minutes left on the game clock. Stewart back to Van der Sloot. Inside to Stewart. Foul will be called on Ipupa. And it's the right foul. There's no way she wanted to get stuck down in the low post trying to defend Stewart. Foul her early if you can. That one's on the floor, so she's not even going to get to the free throw line. Sabaly now. And the rattle is good for Stewart. Soft enough touch to get it onto the front of the rim. Gravity does the rest, and Fenerbahce now hold what could be a decisive lead. They lead by 12. It's a game-high lead for the Turkish team. Stripped away. That will remain Sopron possession, though. Van der Sloot saying she knocked it off the leg of Ipupa. The officials are going to have a conversation. Yeah, that replay looks like it's right. They are going to flip the call. It will be Fenerbahce ball. Timeout has been called here by Coach Gaspar. It's the right call. That's great officiating. Working as a team on that one. Timeout called here by Sopron as the game is starting to slip away from them. Over 5 minutes left. They trail by 12. remember, this is game one of a three-game series, a best-of-three-game series. The second leg will take place on Friday. And if a third game is needed, we will be back here next Wednesday, Wednesday the 22nd, to lock out that three-game series. Remember, at stake, a place in the Final Four. Biggest prize in European women's club basketball on the line. Fenerbahce enter this postseason, you would say, as favourites to take the title, but they know it is not an easy road that they are going to be asked to walk along. They were favourites last year on their home floor and they lost in the final. They want to make amends for that situation. Stewart now. Yagapova. Sabali. Patient basketball from Fenerbahce. Stewart rolls home the three. 18 points, 9 rebounds for Brianna Stewart. Stolen away, Van der Sloot. Stolen back though by Brooks. One thing you've got is players like Yelena Brooks, Feg Vanecki, they are not going to just go out quietly. They are going to fight every second on the floor. They remember the joy of lifting that trophy, of bringing that trophy home. Feg Vanecki too heavy though with the three ball. They do remember, they know how much it meant to the people of Sopron. The huge celebrations in the streets. They would love to do it again. How huge would that be? Back-to-back titles. Nice pass by Van der Sloot, though. Just putting Sopron's defense into a spin and then placing the perfect pass inside to Messerman. It's got the crowd bouncing. Big Vanecki now to Brooks. Oh, hands by Messerman to Stewart. Off the glass, the easy two, and Fenerbahce are starting to run away with this one. A 19-point lead now for the Turkish team. 3.5 minutes to play. Our Sopron running out of gas here in Istanbul. Feg Vanecki. Back to Brooks. Inside to McBegor. Which goes strong. Draws the foul. 3-point play opportunity here for the Australian McBegor. Sabali just not able to stop her. McBegor just too strong for her, really. Sabali just getting herself caught too low in the restricted area. Unless McBegor really swings an elbow, it's only going to end one way. As Messman heads to the bench for Fenerbahce, back in comes Stokes. McBegor to complete the 3-point play, and she does. Gashbar will call a time, will call a sub as well. Sopron's trail by 16 now. Fenerbahce have done a real job here in the fourth quarter. Some of the experience and quality has shone through here for Fenerbahce. A little bit of time management, you imagine, for the Turkish team now. Yagapova to Sabali, gets the roll. Selfless play there from Yagapova. Could have taken the shot herself instead. Picks up her second assist of the game. Stolen away the whole game now. Flowing the way of Fenerbahce. Long pass. That's a poor pass from Yagapova. Starting to get a little bit too loose too soon. Still 2 minutes and 35 left on the game clock. But the home team lead by 18. As they start to move towards picking up this game one win. Turner now. Varga into the game for the first time. Off the glass, it's knocked away by Stankovic. So it will be a Fenerbahce ball. The fans are starting to enjoy themselves, and usually here in Istanbul, that means one thing, and that means that the home team are on the verge of another big victory. Remember, this would be number 13 in a row. Fenerbahce, backdoor cut, Vanderslut, easy two. The game is becoming a little too easy here for Fenerbahce now. 2 minutes to play, they lead by 20. It has been a close game throughout. It really has been just this fourth quarter where the game's been opened up. Chopin have just scored 4 points in over 8 minutes of basketball. And when you play Fenerbahce, you are not going to win games if you score at that rate. Rebound pulled in by Chukor. Turner kicks it out. Kicked away and saved in bounds by Yagapova. And the party is starting as the game one win is almost there for Fenerbahce. Putting to bed maybe a few of the demons from last year's final where Sopron beat them here in Istanbul. I'm sure plenty of the fans here tonight were there and were heartbroken with the players. Stewart heads to the bench. 20 points, 10 rebound performance for Brianna Stewart. Into the game comes Latza for her first taste of the action. And the Sloot now, slowing things down. Shot clock at 4. Amanda Sloot's going to have to put it up. She's not. That's going to be a shot clock violation. And for Coach Gaspar now, it's maybe about just trying to build a little bit of confidence or at least not lose any more confidence in his final minute of 5 seconds. Game one's destiny may have been decided. Fenerbahce may be going one up, but he now has to think about Friday. They will bring this battle back to their home floor in Hungary. And it's about having a bit of confidence and a bit of composure and something positive to take back. Burundi gets blocked. Ratsa picks up the loose ball rebound. Final minute now of the fourth quarter here in Istanbul. What a game we've had. What a way to open up this year's playoffs. This year's EuroLeague Women quarterfinal. Ratsa to Yagapova. Yagapova, three ball, a little heavy. Rebound batted back. Stokes will bring it down and hand it to Chaka, and they're going to try and run the clock out. And this will be a game one win for Fenerbahce. That is huge. Some of the demons to rest here. As the final buzzer sounds here in Istanbul, game one of the quarterfinal series between Fenerbahce and Sopron goes the way of the top seed, Fenerbahce. They've won this one 82-62. That is an impressive performance from Fenerbahce. A 20-point game one win for them. Fenerbahce 82, Sopron 62. From the home team, one step closer to the final four, one step closer to lifting the trophy they so desire. And it was that huge fourth quarter performance, outscoring Sopron 20-4 in the final 10 minutes, and a real team performance. Leading all scorers, Brianna Stewart ended up with a double-double, 20 points, 10 rebounds, but they had four other players in double digits. Emma Messerman, 15 points, 6 rebounds, 4 assists and 4 steals. On 13 points, Sabali and Yagapova. And then on 12 points, Kayla McBride, who was 4 from 5 from downtown, doing her thing from distance. As for Sopron, just one player making it to double digits, Ezzy McBegor, 17 points, 3 rebounds and 5 assists. Turner had 9 points. Kunek, Fegvenecki and Burundi all had 7, and Brooks had 9 as well. Fenerbahce fans rightfully celebrating. Game one locked in. Fenerbahce now have the opportunity on Friday to head to Hungary and have the chance of securing their spot at the final fours. Final score here in Istanbul is Fenerbahce 82, Shopron 62. Thank you so much for joining me. Make sure you stay tuned in to all of the EuroLeague Women playoff action over the next 8 days. There's plenty coming your way, and it will be phenomenal. Thanks for joining me. I will see you soon.
Nasıl benziyorsun?